From those around, I hear a cry, a muffled sob, a hopeless sigh. I hear their footsteps leaving slow, and then I know my soul must fly. From those around, I hear a cry, a muffled sob, a hopeless sigh. I hear their footsteps leaving slow.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. My name is Salim Hassani and I'm your host for this program, From Birth Until Death. In the previous episodes, we've been discussing the rulings pertaining to the newborn child, and in particular in the last two episodes, we've been discussing breastfeeding and the certain rulings that apply to that. With us today once again is Sheikh Haitham Al-Haddad. Assalamu alaikum
wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
How are you today, Sheikh?
Alhamdulillah, jazakallah khair.
Barakallahu fiik. Sheikh, in the previous episodes, we were talking about breastfeeding and the relationship that has or that takes upon not only the mother or the person that has breastfed the child, but also if she was to be married. So we're just going to continue on with that, if that's okay with you.
Yes, bismillah wa salatu wa salamu ala rasulillah. We introduced that principle that is known as laban al-fahl.
Yes.
The milk of the man.
Yes.
Or the milk belongs to the man.
Yes.
And we said that, and I gave this example just to make it easy for the audience.
Yes.
I have my wife and children.
Yes.
My wife is feeding my children.
Yes.
And then your child.
Yes.
Has been fed by my wife.
Yes.
Okay. Then your child becomes her son.
Yes.
By breastfeeding, of course. And he also becomes my son.
Yes.
Out of breastfeeding.
Yes.
He becomes my son.
Yes.
So what does that mean? It means that my brother will be the uncle of your child.
Correct, yes.
And this is the incident that took place with Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha.
Right.
Okay, so the brother of the man who was married to the lady that breastfed Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, he came to Aisha and he said, I am your uncle.
Yes.
Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha said, but your brother did not give me milk.
Yes.
Your brother's wife was the one who gave me milk.
Yes.
So the Prophet ﷺ said, "Innahu ammuki." He is your uncle.
Yes.
And this concept is widely accepted by most of the scholars. Still some differences. Well, I don't want to get into them because they might confuse our audience.
Sure.
But generally speaking, this is accepted.
Okay.
Now, what does that mean when we talk about consequences?
Yes.
It means that when I become the father of your child, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, يَحْرُمُ مِنَ الرَّضَاعِ مَا يَحْرُمُ مِنْ النَّسَبِ.
Yes.
What is forbidden by nasab, by lineage, will be forbidden by breastfeeding.
Yes.
Why, what is forbidden, and this is, subhanAllah, a very profound statement. And it is a principle itself. And it has been reported by Aisha, Ali bin Abi Talib, and so on.
Okay.
That what is prohibited by lineage,
yes,
will be prohibited by rada',
by the breastfeeding.
By breastfeeding. So, now, my brother will be the uncle of your son.
Yes.
Or your child.
Yes.
My father will be what?
Your father will then be the grandfather.
The grandfather of your child.
Yes.
Okay. Now, I hope that this is clear.
Yes.
And of course, my sister will be what? The auntie of your
child.
A child.
Yes.
Now, I hope that the brothers and sisters are aware of this point. Now, let me just go one step further.
Okay.
My daughters or my children will become your child, brothers and sisters.
Yes.
Now, people will say, why are you mentioning this in particular? Because my children are the children from my wife.
Yes.
That has gave milk to your son.
Yes.
No, not only this. Imagine that I was married to two wives.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I hope that my wife does not listen to this and she might... I think that I'm truly married and she will give me a hard time. Imagine I'm married to two wives.
Yes.
Wife A, wife B.
Yes.
Wife A is the one who gave milk to your child.
Okay.
So her children will become what? Will become your child's brothers and sisters.
Yes.
Now I became the father of your child.
Yes.
As a result of this, my children from wife B,
yes,
because they are my children, and I am their father, and I am your son's father as
yes.
well,
yes,
or your child's father.
Yes.
So I am the father of all.
Right.
So your child becomes what?
Becomes
a brother or a sister for yes. my children from my other wife.
Right. Okay.
Okay. So this is the ruling of Laban al-Fahl.
Right.
Or the milk of the man.
Okay.
In fact, if we just want to elaborate on this, of course, there are some other rulings that can be extracted from this. But I would like to mention a question that is always posed as a quiz. Yeah, in competitions. They say that a person, a child, suckled from a lady, but she does not become his mother.
Okay.
How? They said that a child suckled. Of course, we can say that the answer for this is easy.
Mm-hmm.
It means that he did not suckle enough.
Yes.
No, they said that the question is, a child suckled from a lady, yet he does not have a mother by breastfeeding.
Okay.
He already suckled.
Yes.
But he does not have a mother by breastfeeding.
Okay.
And he suckled, okay, he suckled in a way that he became a son for a father, yet he does not have a mother.
Okay.
By breastfeeding. They said that a person, let us take my example again, imagining that I'm married to two wives.
Yes.
Wife A and wife B.
Yes.
Your son.
Yes.
Wife A.
Yes.
My first wife.
Yes.
Breastfed him for two times only.
Okay.
And then my second wife breastfed him for three times.
Okay.
Or more than that.
Right.
Just three times. Let us say three times in order to make it simple.
Okay.
In total, your son
yes.
was breastfed by my milk for how many times?
Five times. Yes.
But your son was breastfed by my first wife two times.
Yes.
So according to the Jumhur, she is not his mother.
Correct. Yes.
And the other wife gave him milk three meals.
Yes.
And according to the opinion of the Jumhur,
yes.
the majority of scholars, this is not enough to make her his mother.
Mother, yes.
So, as a result of them, as a result of this, neither of them become what? Become the mother of your child.
Right.
Despite the fact, both of them, what? Fed him.
Yes.
But he becomes what?
He becomes your son.
He becomes my son.
Yes.
Okay. Now, the children from this wife and this wife, they do not become his brothers and sisters because he suckled from their mother. No, they become his brothers and sisters because they suckled with him from my milk.
Yes, so it's because of you.
Because of me.
Yes.
Not because of my wife's.
Right.
So this is one of the consequences. Of course, there are some other questions. They say, what is that question? A person says, my brother got married to my sister.
Mm.
Okay, let us not get into this. Otherwise, the audience will be confused and we have maybe some other points to cover.
Okay, JazakAllah khair for explaining that, Sheikh. On the topic of consequences, we've been talking about them. Is there any other consequences you'd like to mention at all?
Yes, so we said that the main consequence is what is mentioned in Hadith. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when he said that what is prohibited by lineage will be prohibited by breastfeeding.
Yes.
Now, they said that this hadith does not talk about other types of tahrim, other types of haram relationship between the ladies and men.
Okay.
In another word, you know, tahrim or mahramiyya, as they say, mahramiyya means this lady is haram for this man.
Yes.
So he becomes mahram for her.
Okay.
There are three ways to make this mahramiyya, this kind of relationship. Lineage.
Yes.
Lineage. Blood lineage.
Yes.
And breastfeeding.
Yes.
And the third one is musahara, marriage.
Marriage, yes.
Okay. Now, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the hadith that we just mentioned, he mentioned what? Lineage only.
Yes.
He did not mention what?
He don't mention any of the other.
Marriage.
Yes.
So, he said that breastfeeding is equal to what? To marriage.
Yes.
Lineage.
Lineage, yes.
It is not equal to marriage.
Yes.
So now, marriage, is it included in as a reason to make mahramiyya because of breastfeeding or not? I'll give some examples. Let us take the example of your son,
yes,
who becomes my son,
okay,
because out of breastfeeding.
Yes.
Your son grew up and he got married.
Yes.
Now, my son, my blood son by lineage,
yes,
if he got married, his wife is what? Is haram for me.
Yes.
And there is mahramiyya,
yes,
between me and her.
Yes.
I am her mahram.
Yes.
But what about your son that I became his father by breastfeeding? Okay?
Yes, yes.
The Jumhur, most of the scholars believe that, no, I do not become mahram for your son's wife.
Right.
So I cannot see her.
Yes.
Okay?
Okay.
Similarly, why? Because my daughter-in-law, she became haram to me or for me out of what? Out of marriage.
Yes.
Not because of lineage.
Yeah.
And we said that there are three types. The first type is what? Lineage, yes, blood. The second is breastfeeding. And the third one is what?
The marriage.
Musahara.
Yes.
Which is marriage.
Yes.
So she became haram for me out of what? Out of musahara, out of marriage.
Yes.
So they said that this is not included in the hadith because the Prophet ﷺ said, يَحْرُمُ مِنَ الرَّضَاعِ مَا يَحْرُمُ مِنَ النَّسَبِ. Lineage and rada'a.
Yes.
Lineage and breastfeeding.
Yes.
He did not mention tahrim in general or tahrim because of marriage.
Yes.
Okay. So in this case again, your son, who is my son by breastfeeding, yes, if he got married.
Okay, JazakAllah khair, Sheikh, for your time. We're just going to take a short break, and then when we come back, we'll continue the discussion. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Come on, my brothers, let us pray. Decide it now, do not delay.
Imagine that the NBA, they were the ones that were the most beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they had the hardest life.
He assumed that he had some kind of superiority and he was a better, more chosen, you know, a select, better person because he had this wealth. And then you look at all the other people who had wealth, and some of them were the worst people. He had Fir'aun and
reviving your niyyah time and again, that you're doing insincerely for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Most of the youth, they think, oh, I'm going to pray when I'm old, it's okay, now I'll have fun in my life. Later on, I'll work, I'll grow my beard, I'll pray 5 times a day. And all these things, they think that that's later on in life, and they don't know when they will die.
Amira, who's your role model?
Khadija radiallahu anha.
And why?
Because she was Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's wife, and she was the first lady to believe in Islam.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, and welcome back after the break to this program, From Birth Until Death. We're just going to continue now, as we've been doing, and looking at breastfeeding. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Sheikh, before the break, you were talking about some of the consequences, and you were in the middle of giving an example about some of the consequences of breastfeeding and the difference between lineage and marriage. If we could just continue with that for the moment.
Yeah. Bismillah wa salatu wa salam ala rasulillah. We gave the example, and I think now it is clear that your child, who is my child, out of breastfeeding,
yes,
if he got married, then his wife, who is haram for you,
yes,
because he is your son by lineage,
mm-hmm,
but she will not become haram for me because your son, who is my son, is what? My son out of breastfeeding.
Yes.
So his wife will not become haram for me, and I will not become mahram for her.
Yes.
Similarly, they said that if I get married,
yes,
myself to a lady, and her mother becomes haram. If I get married to a lady,
yes,
then that lady, does it become haram for my son by breastfeeding?
Okay? Yes.
I hope that the matter is clear.
Yes.
Okay? So, anyway, we don't want to confuse our viewers, but what we want to say that there is a difference between haram by or mahramiyya by lineage and by breastfeeding.
Yes.
And we said, let us remember the three reasons for making the mahramiyya.
Yes.
Lineage,
yes,
breastfeeding, and marriage.
Yes.
Breastfeeding is equal to lineage.
Yes.
And it is not equal to marriage.
Right.
Full stop.
Jazakallah khair, Sheikh, for explaining this very tricky topic, which is often difficult to sometimes get your head around.
Mm.
And now we've just been talking about breastfeeding and the consequences as well. Often sometimes you hear of sometimes a woman may express some milk and then give that milk to another baby, but it's not directly from her breast as such. Does this have any particular consequences or rulings?
Yeah, this is a good question, and it is a very common question. And they said, almost all scholars said that the ruling is not connected to suckling.
Mm.
The ruling is connected to what? Being fed by the milk.
Mm, the milk, okay.
So if she... produced, or what is the best way to describe it? Take the milk out, or
to express the milk.
To express the milk in any container, and she just gave it to the child, and the child, or in a bottle, and the child started to be fed from the bottle,
yes,
not from the breast itself.
Yes.
Then the ruling is established.
Okay.
And almost there is no difference of opinions between scholars regarding this. Except, of course, there are some odd opinions in,
yes,
each case, but generally speaking, this is the established ruling.
Okay, jazakallah khair. And often another common question we find is that sometimes the milk may be mixed with some other substances or something else. Mm. How does this impact?
Yes, some mothers, they say that their children do not accept any other milk.
Mm-hmm.
Or other children, they do not accept their milk,
mm,
unless they put, for example, honey or something, yeah, of different taste.
Yes.
So, for example, if they express the milk in a bottle and they added some sugar, some honey, will that change the ruling? No, it does not change the ruling.
Okay.
It does not change the ruling. By the way, you remember when we said that it should be 5 meals?
Yes.
Now, how do we calculate 5 meals if the son, if the child is suckling from the bottle?
Mm-hmm.
We said in terms of from the breast itself,
yes,
the child has to suckle until himself feels enough and leave it.
Yes.
This is considered, according to the opinion of most of the scholars, as one.
Yes.
Not he is not removed by his mother.
Yes.
No. He fed by himself until he is full or she is full.
Yes.
And then he moved away to, for example, to breathe or to relax, and then he went again.
Yes.
So these are considered to be two suckles.
Yes.
Now, in terms of the bottle, again, if the child start to suck, and then he left the bottle by himself, we have not removed it.
Yes.
Ourselves, then that is considered to be one meal or one suckle.
Right.
So if he had five out of those, then the rule will be established.
Okay.
Even if the milk has been mixed with some other thing. Now, we have to be careful. If the milk is very, very little, and the substance, the main substance is formula, or, you know, other milk, and they just put little bit of the milk, then if that milk that has been added by the mother is neglected compared to the formula that has been given to the child, then that might not have the same ruling unless this process has been repeated so many times to conclude that the child was fed five complete meals by the milk of that lady.
Okay. All right. Jazakallah khair once again, Sheikh. Now, we also hear about milk banks where the milks are stored. How does this relate in this matter?
Yeah, this is a very interesting concept. Of course, this is a very strange concept. And I remember, by the way, I was studying with Sheikh Ibn Baz, rahimahullahu ta'ala, and we came to the topic of breastfeeding. And then I asked him about this question. I don't know why I asked him about this question, because I read it somewhere or something. So I asked him about this question. And the Sheikh, rahimahullah, did not like this question.
Oh.
Did not like this question. And then he said the other question, the coming question.
Okay.
And this was a long time ago. Now, but there are some studies now by the OIC councils, fiqh councils,
right,
regarding bunuk al-halib. They call it bunuk al-halib, or milk banks.
Yes.
And they said that, generally speaking, that should not be established.
Oh,
okay. If there is a real need for it, that can be established. But if the person can avoid using it, that is better, because it will mix between what is haram, what is halal.
Right.
Because many women, they will provide milk, and then the children will start be fed by that milk, and then we will not be able to know who is who, who belongs to who.
Yes.
So that should be really avoided.
Right.
And, you know, some scholars, even I think Sheikh Ibn Uthaymeen said that it is haram.
Right.
Because of what it may lead to.
Okay.
And alhamdulillah, now, you know, we have the formula, we have other types of milk that can be fed to the children.
Okay, alhamdulillah. So in general, it's something we should try and avoid.
Definitely.
Okay, jazakallah khair. Now, with regards to breastfeeding in this topic, we mentioned that it can often be for a lengthy period of time. Now, sometimes there are some women who maybe haven't performed Hajj, or maybe they've, for some reason, they haven't been able to, and maybe the time has come where they've been able to now perform Hajj, yet they're breastfeeding. So what do we do in this situation, Sheikh? We've only got 1 minute, I've just been told.
Anyway, if they can provide their food for their children by any other mean, or give their children to be fed by other ladies, of course they can do this.
Okay.
Otherwise, they should delay the Hajj.
Okay. Jazakallah khair for this very short answer, Sheikh. And this is the conclusion of another episode. Inshallah, in the further episodes, we'll be looking once again at the newborn and the upbringing, and we'll be going further into the life of the newborn. جزاكم الله خير والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
From those around I hear a cry, a muffled sob, a hopeless sigh. I hear their footsteps leaving slow, and then I know my soul must fly. At last it comes to heaven or hell, decide which now, do not delay. Come on, my brothers, let us pray. Decide which now, do not delay. Come on, my brothers, let us pray. Decide which now, do not delay. From those around, I hear a cry, a muffled sob, a hopeless sigh. Hear their footsteps leaving slow.